This afternoon, you're going to have your math games. And what you're going to do is you're going to start at one center and then go to the next center after we get a chance to play it for a certain amount of time. Go ahead and get started with the game that you're at, the center that you're at.
The children here are in third to fifth grade.
What are you doing here, DeAndre?
We're playing fraction dominoes.
Okay, and what are you doing with the dominoes?
We have to find the answer on the dominoes, and we have to put them.
Which answer?
Like one-fourth. You have to put the one-fourth right there.
With the picture of one-fourth? So you're putting the fraction of one-fourth with the picture of one-fourth.
The after-school program has the constant communication with the day school program.
If I took a line and drew it in the middle of this, what do I have?
So in the after-school program, they can go ahead and get that extra reinforcement for basic facts and then still come into the classroom and be successful.
Can you find a fraction like two-thirds that is not two-thirds? It's going to have the same area, but not the same name. That's a challenge.
The games are basically to go beyond that drill and practice to really drive home those critical thinking skills, those alternative strategies, or those alternate algorithms that kids can create on their own.
Okay, so then now you know that 4/6 is the equivalent fraction to what?
Two-thirds.
Two-thirds. Okay, I'm gonna challenge you to find another one. See one that's similar or equivalent to 1/4. That's gonna have the same value, but a different name. Okay, now I'm going to give you a challenge. If I say that this is one whole piece, right? Is there a way that I can make other pieces equal this piece?
Yes.
Show it to me.
What my questioning always drives to, I'm trying to get them to critically evaluate the material and then relate it to something else that they know about, or something else that they've experienced, so that when they get to a testing situation, if it's something that's unfamiliar, they can then relate it to what they do know and still be able to solve problems.
Okay. So how many pieces do we have here?
Six.
Which one?
You got six? Okay, so if I have just this by itself, what fraction of this yellow is this green piece?
One sixth.
And if I have two pieces, what fraction of this yellow piece are these two green pieces?
2/6.
Now what do I have?
3/6.
Okay, it's 3/6.
I love being able to ask them questions because it gives me the exact point where they're not understanding. So I can help lead them to where they need to be with questions.
3/6.
3/6 and 1/2. Are those equivalent? Are those equal?
Equal.
What are you doing here?
We have to find the class. Like if it says quarter past 11, we have to find the quarter past 11.
What is quarter past 11? What is quarter? What is a quarter of an hour? How many minutes?
Quarter past 25.
A quarter?
25 cents.
You think it's 25 cents?
Even if they have a wrong answer, you have to still pull out what was right about the answer and then steer them with another question in a way that they can arrive to the right answer.
Actually, that a quarter is 25, but when we're talking about time, we only have what? How many minutes?
12.
In an hour. You know how many minutes are in an hour?
60
minutes are in an hour. So if I think of a clock being 60 minutes, I can split it up into four separate pieces.
So, is the quarter past 15
minutes?
Yes, ma'am. Anytime that they talk with each other and they share ideas, that always increases their prior knowledge, and that prior knowledge is essential for them to be successful in the classroom.
11:15.
I have it.
I'm running out. Equivalency, that's when we talk about fractions.
Centers are a good activity for the ability to choose. And once they become comfortable with the activities that they're choosing, they're going to start to choose more and more difficult tasks, which is always going to enhance their critical thinking skills.
I'm blue. Paper, rock, scissors, whoever goes first.
We're playing a board game with math. We're learning, like,
how to subtract, how to add and multiply. It was fun because I was with my friends and we were having a good time learning together.
You know another name for a number sentence?
With math, I think you have to have a genuine like for, you have to have a sincere concern for helping the students build bridges for their gaps of understanding.